Hello ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the video to show you how to install Starsector and get it ready for modding. First things first, you need to come to the website fractalsoftworks.com/blog and either buy, or if you already bought, download the new Starsector, Starsector 0.8.1a. This one is a 0.8.1 release candidate 7, which is the one from the hotfixes of the 4th of June. I have it already here, I put it in this folder here, and to install it, it's very, very simple. Everyone's done it before. Double click. Windows doesn't really like it. Ignore that. You can trust Alex. Alex is a good... Oops. Wrong button. You can trust that now. More info. Run anyway. Windows is very protective of itself. Right. Run the install. Very, very simple. I'm going to put it in D drive. In the D drive start sector. That's where I personally want to put it. I'm not going to create a start menu shortcut because I'm just like that. I'm just going to install. And it's very, very simple, quick, simple, easy. Everyone's installed something like this before. If you haven't, there you go. Quiz, finish. First of all, just make sure it runs. And it'll open up the launcher here. Make sure you've got your resolution set to what you want. Full screen, sound. If you have any mods, they'll be here, but you won't have any mods yet because you've freshly installed the game. So that'll be empty. Just hit Starsector, play Starsector, and good. Good capture software. You did well. Just make sure it runs. First thing first, always just make sure it runs. Make sure you got no other problems. Here you go. We have ourselves Starsector there. This is also... go away. So Starsector 0.8.1a RC7. Just making sure it runs. Once you've made sure it runs, just hop out. If at this point, at some point during that point, if you've never actually installed Starsector on this computer before, it'll ask you for your key. If you have ever installed Starsector on your computer before, Starsector will remember, so there will be no key required. If you don't get a key query, it's because you've already had Starsector installed in your computer. Okay, right. Now we can get rid of this, or keep it, but I'm going to get rid of it. So, now, the most important part about getting Starsector ready for mods is increasing the memory usage that Java is allowed to have. Now, this new version of Starsector is very clever. If you have a 32-bit computer, it'll automatically give you 32-bit Java 7. If you've got a 64-bit computer, it'll automatically give you 64-bit Java 7. This is a big change from this new version, is it automatically gives you 64-bit Java 7. This is very, very good news. Now, if you have 32-bit Java 7, you're pretty much done. What you would have to do is change vmparams, but vmparams comes pretty much as good as you want it for 32-bit. But stick with me just in case. Now, if you have 64-bit and more RAM to work with, the file you need to change to allow more RAM to be used by Starsector is vmparams. So the first thing we want to do is create a backup. Always create a backup of anything you edit, anytime, just in case it all goes wrong. You can always go back to this. Right, so we got our backup over there. Let's open up vmparams. I'm going to use Notepad for ease of use, but you guys can use any text editor you want. Now, this is vmparams here. Now, most of this, ignore most of this. You don't need to know most of this. The numbers that you care about are these two. These two numbers here. If you have 32-bit Starsector and 32-bit Java, these numbers are going to say 1024. Pretty much leave them there, but we'll get back, we'll carry on with that. Now, this number here is the amount of memory in megabytes, M, that Java is allowed to start with. And this number here is the amount of megabytes that Java is allowed to end up with. So if you have 32-bit, it'll be 1024, 1024. If you have 32-bit internet and say 3 gigs of RAM, you can raise that to about 1300. 1300 here, 1300 here, and that is the max. If you've got 32-bit, I'm sorry, your computer just can't handle that much memory. And you do your best. I mean, Starsector is great. We've very little mods. I would suggest taking like low impact mods, maybe one faction or two, rather than getting everything at once. If you have a 64-bit computer and say 4, 8, 12, 16 gigs, it becomes a little bit better. You can raise these. I have quite a bit of RAM, so I'm gonna raise this to about, we're gonna start with 4 gigs, which is 4096. And then I'm going to raise that all the way up to 8 gigs, which is 8, 96 times 2 is 200, No, it's not 200, it's 192. There we go. Like in maths. What this means is that my star sector will start up with 4 gigs of assigned memory and go all the way up to 8 gigs if it has to. Two rules about this. One, never set this number here higher than half your maximum RAM. Just because, for safety, right? You want your RAM to your to let Windows do its stuff. Personally, I wouldn't set the XMX higher than half your maximum RAM. And also, I wouldn't set it anywhere higher than 8 gigs anyway. Any higher than 8 gigs and you might start having a little bit of issues. And let's be honest, like, if you could go from 4 gigs to 8 gigs, that's fine. Like, Star Sector probably doesn't need more to start with. Like, if you have only 8 gigs of RAM, and you can only do from 2 to 4 gigs, like, say, 2048 to 4096, that's probably fine. That is probably fine. Like, 4 gigs is plenty. I just, if you have extra bit of RAM to spare, might as well, you know? And that's pretty much it. You save that, save it, file, save. Remember, if anything goes wrong, you've got your backup params here. Just make sure it works. Always make sure it works. Like, whenever you're doing anything, just make sure it works before you progress to the next step. If you take 10 steps at once and then it doesn't work, you have to check every single step at a time. Just good. Everything's fine. Shadowplay is still there. Go away, Shadowplay. Good. That runs. Fine. Now, when you have your mods, thank you. When you have your mods, basically go to the forums. Forums. Go to mods. These are all the mods. Some of them, ooh, Next Saturn has updated. There you go. Fantastic news. Next Saturn has updated to 0.8.1a. Either you can look over here and see what mods are compatible, or sometimes you can go into mod index, which is a nice file that has pretty much listings of everything that is compatible. It's a bit behind the times, needs a bit of updating, but I'm sure that'll be updated very, very soon. Yep. So you go over here, you will download a file, you go, for example, let's say I want Next. We know Next Celeron's updated anyway, so you go to Next Celeron. Make sure that every time you get a mod, you have its required, anything that's required. So LazyLib is basic. We all need LazyLib. So we're going to download LazyLib. We're going to put LazyLib in mods. Save that there, just so you see what happens. Save that there. Go into here, go into mods, open up mods. Just unzip it here. Unzip, 7-zip, whatever you want to use. Extract here. Good, LazyLib is there. Go back there, open up Starsector. Go into mods, turn on LazyLib. Or you can clear it to turn on LazyLib. Then play Starsector, make sure it loads. Every time you, if it's the first time, if you know what you're doing and you're more confident in yourself, take more steps at once. If you don't know what you're doing, you're not entirely sure what you're there for, a little bit of time. Add one mod, turn it on, see if it works. Add the next mod, especially if you're doing a lot of factions at once and you want to install all the factions, just do it that way. And if at any point anything goes wrong, you can just over here, clear your mods, go over here, delete VRAMs, and you can just delete this one here, for example, just delete that one there and rename this one back to vmparams by itself. It's back to what it used to be. See, you have to go here and go boom, boom. It's back to what it used to be. And then just make sure it works. And then again, the best place to get any answers to questions if you don't know what you're doing is go in the forums. The people in the forums are very, very awesome. They're very, very helpful. Go to the Discord, the Star Sector Discord. Which I'll put the link in the description, or my own Discord as well, where not always Star Sector, but a lot of people hang around there as well, and it may be a little bit easier to ask for help because there's not a couple of hundred people talking at the same time. Anyway, if you have any other questions, you can also put in the comments. A lot of really awesome people read the comments like you guys, and if you need anything, I'm sure one of them will be very happy to help you. Hope this helped, guys. I'll catch you guys next time. Bye.